Good day everybody. In this video I will explain how to estimate Coulomb's passive and active pressure. We're going to look at this example where we have a retaining wall and we have a backfill material that has a unit weight of 20 kN per square meters. So let's assume it's a sand, so it only has friction angle, which is 30 degrees. And the height of the retaining wall H is 5 meters. So I'm going to show you how we can estimate passive and active pressures, which are shown here in the formulas. You see that the formulas are actually like very similar. The only difference here is we have coefficient of active pressure, and for passive pressure we have coefficient of passive pressure. So the rest is the same. So this will be the unit weight of soil, and that will be the height of the retaining wall in the power of 2. So these are the coefficients, how we can estimate them. So this is for active pressure. This will be for passive pressure. Again, the formulas are very similar. There is only a few differences. So just pay attention when you use the formulas. Let's see what factors we use in these calculations. So first of all, you will see that here we have a friction angle. So this is the friction angle of the soil and it's given as 30 degrees. Here is given as in the effective stress. In many cases, there is no groundwater level in the backfill because there is typically drainage provided. So there is no groundwater level, and most likely that total stresses and effective stresses are going to be the same because the pore pressure is equal to zero. So what else do we have? We have this theta. So theta is the angle that we'll have here. You will see here, this is retaining wall we'll make with the backfill. So typically it can be from like varies from 0 to maybe 10 degrees. So 0, 5 or 10 degrees, that will be reasonable numbers. Also we have, we have this one, which is theta. So theta, it's friction. It's friction between the retaining wall, let's say concrete retaining wall, and the backfill, right? In many cases, the assumption is made that it's going to be half of the friction angle of the soil. So if here we have 30 degrees, divided by 2 will give us 15 degrees. That will be the friction. We don't really know it. So that's, again, it's a good assumption to go with. Okay, so that's about it. Now what we're going to do is just to put numbers in the formula and do the calculations. Let's start with the active pressure. So I'm going to write down here active pressure. Here we're going to have cosine of the power of 2. Friction angle, it's 30 minus theta, that it's 10 degrees, right? So it's all in degrees. So, and then divided by, here will be cosine the power of 2 of 10 degrees. Then times, again, the same function, cosine times, here we have 10 degrees, which is angle theta, plus that friction between soil and the retaining wall, which is 15. Then we're going to have this component, which is 1 plus, we have a square root of sine here. The friction angle between the soil and the wall, it's 15 degrees, plus the friction angle of the soil, which is 30 degrees, times sine, where we have friction angle of soil, 30 minus alpha. Okay, I didn't explain alpha. So alpha, it's a sloping. So most of the time, alpha will be equal to zero. So most of the time, if you look at retaining wall, that will be ground surface here. But if we have a little bit of extra soil, then we need to estimate this angle of alpha. And in this case, the estimation, well, I don't even know. Let's just assume that alpha is equal 5 degrees. So put it here, alpha is equal 5 degrees, so that we can solve the problem, right? So then I have, I'm gonna put here 5 degrees, right? And then divided by, will be a different function of cosine, then that 15 plus 30 degrees here, cosine, you have theta, which is 10 minus alpha 5, right? And that everything in the power of 2. Okay, so I already did the calculations, and the answer will be 0.4048. So that will be the coefficient. So I think what I did, actually, I put the formula in the Excel spreadsheet, and if you do it this way, you can just change, let's say, the values of friction angle, or I don't know, values of alpha, so it will be very easy. The formula is a little bit complicated, like complex, but if you put it in Excel, it will save lots of time for you. Okay, so we get this coefficient. Now let's estimate active pressure. So it will be half of times the coefficient of active pressure, which is 0.4048 times. We have the unit weight of soil is 20, and the height of the wall is 5, put it in the power of 2. So according to my calculations, it's going to give us value of 101.2 kPa. Okay, so that will be active pressure acting on the tectonic wall. So now let's do the estimate the passive pressure. What we can also do, let's just change some numbers. Let's say that there is no sloping and alpha is equal to 0 degrees, which is very common in practice. Also, let's assume that there is no angle theta is equal to 0 degrees. Again, it's very common in practice. Still, we're going to keep the same friction angle, which is 30 degrees. And then the friction between the wall and the soil will be half of that, 15 degrees. So I already did the calculations. It's what you do now. You just use this formula to estimate the value of Kp, which is a coefficient of passive pressure. I already put everything in Excel, did the calculations. So just want to share the answer with you, which is 4.977. So that will be the coefficient. And then let's estimate the passive pressure acting on the wall will be half of this coefficient, 4.977, times the unit weight, which is still the same soil, 20, and the height, it's still the same, 5 meters in the power of 2. That will give us value of 1244.3 kPa. So that will be the answer. So that will be the answer for the passive pressure. You see here we change for the passive pressure we change alpha, and we also change theta, so that we can look at different numbers, different example. So that's how we do it. Well, thanks for watching this video. I hope you've learned something new. Have a nice day. Bye.